The Royal Armoury's collection in Leeds in the UK is home to almost every example of sword ever made. And it now plays host to an experiment that will pitch two iconic swords against each other. The curved samurai sword from Japan versus the straight European broadsword. The broadsword was an ideal cutting weapon, the katana ideal for slashing. So which one is best?
With the abandonment of the feudal system, testing swords on corpses was obviously out of the question. And as a result, substitutes to human bodies were found, and what we're doing today is testing it on bundles of straw.
Straw is a good approximation for the density of human bone. Our samurai contender goes first and easily slices through. And interestingly, the European broadsword, even with its blunter edge, does just as good a job. But European-style swords never caught on in a big way in Japan.
European swords that appeared in Japan had no effect because the Japanese certainly recognised that they weren't forged in the same way as Japanese blades and, quite frankly, regarded them as inferior.
Similar cutting performance, but very different fighting techniques. The broadsword relies on brute strength, and the samurai on speed and fighting finesse. But by the 16th century, a new weapon appeared that challenged both sword and warrior and would change the face of warfare forever. In Japan, guns fired by non-elite soldiers forced the samurai off the battlefield.